Hi, my name's Sophie Pett-Sabine and I'm a child sleep consultant. Now, there is a minefield of information out there for new parents and seasoned parents alike, especially when it comes to sleep. This is really why I'm proud to be collaborating with Maury here today to be able to provide you with some information that's safe and accurate and really useful in helping you and your children sleep better at night. In this first video, I'm going to be talking to you today about a really popular problem that families come to me for support with, and that is transitioning your child from sleeping in a cot to sleeping in a bed. Now, there's several reasons why families may have transitioned their child. Popular ones are that you might have had a new baby come into the family. So the arrival of a sibling is a really important one because the baby needs to come in and take that cot. Another reason is that perhaps your child is an escapee and they're a jumper, so they literally have been launching themselves out of the cot and you think, oh, you know, we need to be safe here and it's probably time to transition to a bed. Another popular reason is that your child perhaps has really resisted bedtime and you feel that they just hate being in their cot. You know, they're rattling at the bars, screaming and yelling, and you feel that they just don't like it in the cot and that they're actually going to sleep better if you put them in a bed. Now, as I say, these are really popular reasons, and what I would say there is, yes, they're valid reasons, but it may not be actually the right time to transition your child. And this is my big tip for you, and the big mistake that I see for a lot of families, that you are moving your child from the cot to the bed too soon, before they are ready. So my number one tip for you is, do not move your child until they are ready. So just moving back there to those reasons why you might be feeling it's time to move your child and addressing those and what you can do to sort of work on those before actually making the transition to the bed. So if you've got a new baby coming in and you think, okay, perhaps we need to make the transition to a bed now so that the older child isn't having to give up their cot to the young baby, I would say that don't worry about that. You know, absolutely, if your older child is happy in the cot, keep them in there. And even if it means, you know, the baby's sleeping in a travel cot or you buying just another cheap second cot, if the baby has outgrown where they would be sleeping as a newborn, then I would advise doing that initially. If they are an escapee or a cot jumper, then yes, obviously we need to make sure that they're safe. But what I would say there, if your child is managing to get out of their cot, it might well be that they're not sleeping in a sleep sack anymore and that you've put them in a duvet. I would say get them back in that sleep sack because that's going to contain them as much as possible. If they have been one of the clever ones that has managed to unzip the sleep sack and get themselves out of it, then I would say that a really good tip for you is to get a sleep sack that has a zip that does up down the front. So I know that Maury have one of those. And then what you do is put that sleep sack on backwards. So the arms go through first and the zip does up at the back. That way your child is unable to reach back to that zip and be able to undo it, take it off and escape out of the cot. So that's a top tip for you there. If you feel that your child just hates being in the cot and, you know, they're really resisting bedtime and it's, you know, full of tears and tantrums, then I would say just have a look at what time your child is going to bed and how well they're napping in the day. I'm thinking that they, you know, are going to be around about 18 months onwards. So it might be a time where you're feeling that they don't need to have a nap in the day. And have really, you know, resisted naps, and it could well be that they're overtired. When we start to see resistance from a child at bedtime, a big part of that can be that they're overtired, that they're not actually bothered by sleeping in the cot or things like that. They're actually okay with that. They're just very, very tired, and that's causing them to resist bedtime. So really look at what we call sleep hygiene. You know, when your child is waking in the morning, are they having enough nap time in the day? And is bedtime an appropriate time for their age? If they are very, very tired, get them down to bed earlier. So there are a few tips to kind of help you with the manage the reasons why you might be considering moving your child. But the other big thing I want to say to you is do not move them too soon, because this is where many families are going wrong. If your child is not old enough to understand the rules of sleeping in a bed, i.e., they need to stay in it and not wander around their room or the house in the middle of the night, then they're not ready to move to that bed. So people often say to me, well, what is the best age? And there is no right age, because obviously every child develops at a different rate and they understand things at a different rate. But if we were to choose an age, I would say the longer you can keep your child in their cot, the better. And if you can get to age three, that for me is ideal, because we would know that a child at that age is really able to understand, the rules and the boundaries that we need to set in place for them when they're moving to that bed. Consider things like, is your child asking to sleep in a bed? Are they saying, I want to be like a friend, or I want to be a big boy, a big girl now, and I don't want to be a baby anymore in the cot? If they are, great. They really have that cognitive understanding of what's going to happen when they move into a bed. So that's my number one tip for you. Keep them in there as long as possible. And make sure that they're going to understand the rules and boundaries of when you do move them. So the first thing I want you to do is to make their bedroom nice and safe. You may need to install a baby gate at their door to stop them wandering around the house in the middle of the night. And if there's any heavy furniture, such as wardrobes, chest of drawers, bookcases that are freestanding, you may need to secure those to the wall, so that if your child is walking around in the night and it's dark time, that they're not climbing or pulling on something, and there's no danger of it toppling over. That's very important. So once the room is safe and secure, then you need to sit down and talk to your child about the boundaries. Explain to them what's expected, that they settle down to sleep at night and they stay in their bed until it's time to wake up in the morning. Ask them whether they understand what they need to do. And obviously, they should be at the age where they do understand it and they're able to verbally communicate with you that they do understand those rules. So, once it's that time, the big day is happening, your child is very excited about the bed and the new bedding, and they're a big boy or a big girl. Bear in mind that you may need to offer some extra support to them whilst this change is bedding in. So it may well be that you need to sit next to their bed and offer them the comfort knowing that you're there, and obviously helping them to stay in the bed. And that's great, that's fine. But how I want you to work this is to phase that out over a number of days. And I would say no more than a week there. Yes, you may start off by holding your child's hand or there being some sort of touch and comfort and support from them, but you have to move away from that over a number of days. So sitting by the bed and gradually moving away from the bed until a point that you're sat outside of the door. Now, the timing of this is really key, because if you start to sit by the side of the bed or let your child hold your hand, they are in control of that. So I want you to be in control of that touch and you to be in control of where you will be sitting. And like I say, let this process be no longer than a week, because if you end up sitting in the same place for nights on end, that is going to become the new normal for your child, and they are going to really resist that change when you try to move. So we want to make small steps, offering lots of reassurance and comfort for them, but over a number of days. Make sure that you're taking a step forward and a step away from the side of the bed or from that support over a number of days. And that way you're offering a consistent supportive message for your child, but also not having them rely on you always being in the room with them together. So just to recap the points here, the big mistake that lots of families make is moving your child too soon. Ideally, wait until they're in their third year, but if you can keep them in their cot for as long as possible, that is going to be the best thing for you. Make sure that they understand the rules that it takes for them to be sleeping in a new bed. If your child is resisting their cot for whatever reason, make sure that they're sleeping enough in the day, going down to bed at the right time at night. If you've got an escapee, you can use the sleep sack trick and switch that around. And don't be worried about moving your child out of their cot in preparation for their sibling. The best advice there is to go with two cots if you really, really need to and there's not enough gap. But I tend to find that if a child is old enough to move out, to understand moving out of their cot, that they're not going to mind giving it up for their sibling because they're going to feel that they're old enough for it and they'll be quite happy to get rid of that cot. I really hope that they have been useful tips for you today. And yeah, that the transition, whenever you make it, is going to go safely and smoothly for you. See you again in the next video. Bye bye.